In this video, I'm going to talk about the difference between ortho and polar as we're drawing objects in AutoCAD. So I'm going to start with the line command. And right now, if you notice, I'm just going to click somewhere to start the line command. I can draw this line at any angle that I want. It's called the rubber band effect. And so basically one end is pinned down. It's like pinning down one end of a rubber band, and I can make it any length. I can make it any angle that I'd like. I'm going to press escape to get out of that command, and I'll come over here and show you. We have these two icons here. One is called ortho mode and one is called polar tracking. So you cannot have both of them on at the same time. It's one or the other. You can have them both off, which I do right now. But as you start to use them, I'm going to show you the difference between the two. Notice if I hover over ortho mode, it tells me F8 is the function key that I can press on my keyboard to turn it on and off. And F10 turns my polar on and off. So if I turn on my ortho and I come back to that same line command and pull, look what it's doing. It is only letting me make a perfectly horizontal and a perfectly vertical line. So it kind of locks me into vertical and horizontal lines. This is really nice to have when you know you're working with perfectly vertical, perfectly horizontal lines, and you don't want to accidentally mess it up. So if I press, F8 to turn it off. Now, if I tried to visually do it and I needed it perfectly horizontal, look, I'm visually trying to do it, but I'm still at like 1 degree. So if I turn on my F8 or turn on my ortho, then it just locks me into it. What's nice about this command is you can continue drawing, and the minute you don't need it, just press F8 and you can continue drawing without it. So that, I'm going to type U enter to undo what I just did. And the next one we're going to turn on, instead of having ortho on, we're going to turn polar on. With polar, I'm going to start the line command. Again, just kind of click wherever I want to start it. It looks like I can draw my line at any angle that I want. But as I start getting close to angle zero, look, it kind of snaps me to it and it puts this guideline. Do you see that dashed guideline? So it's trying to help me. It's guiding me into that perfectly horizontal and the perfectly vertical line, but I have more flexibility. I'm not locked into it. So that's the difference between ortho and polar. I can have them both off and I can draw my lines at any angle that I want, but if I really want to kind of lock it down and make sure that I want to make perfectly vertical and horizontal lines, I'm going to go for polar, or I'm sorry, ortho. And if I want to have some flexibility but then be guided into those set increments, then I will turn on my polar. Now let's go look at the properties. If I look next to the ortho and polar icons, if I click on this down arrow, I actually can choose. We can see it's checked so that my polar is set to 90 degree increments. So 90, 180, 270, 360. I can set it to 45 degree increments, 30 degree increments, and it's got lots of options for me to choose here. Let's go 15 and you can see what happens. So every 15, so here's my 15 degrees, and here's my 30, and my 45, it's just guiding me at every 15 degree increment. So we're not locked into 90 degree increments. We can choose any of these. We can also go into tracking settings, and notice my it's turned on. It's got a little check mark next to it. My increment angle was set to 15. I could set it back, maybe set it to 45. What's cool is I can click this and give it a new angle. And let's say that I need 43 degrees. I want it to guide me at 43 degrees. So as I turn, I do my line command. It is guiding me right when I get to 43, almost there. There we go, 43 degrees and 45. I had set it to 43 and 45, but you can tell it which angle you want it to guide you at. I'm gonna go to tracking settings again. And another thing that you can do is right here, you can do absolute angles, which means it's coming from 0, 0, with the angle 0 being always due east, or you can say relative to last segment. So I'll come in here, I'm going to draw a line at any random angle, and then notice that I can go relative to that angle. Look, I'm going 90 degrees. This is not truly 90 degrees. It's just relative to that angle. So relative to that last angle, here's 45 degrees. So you've got a couple of options in there that you can play around with. Tracking settings, typically we just leave it at absolute, and you can set it to whichever angle it is that you wanted to use. Say okay to that, and there you go.